This week on YouTube Masterpiece Theater, The Art of the Channel Banner. What's good, YouTube? It's your boy Malik, back on your screen with another tip for the two. Robin Chris 2.0 asked me, can you make a video on how to make a banner for your channel? I always try and none of my pictures ever work. Robin Chris 2.0, you know I got the YouTube skills that pays the bills, so I'm gonna show you how to get it done. Let's jump off into some photo editors and knock this out. Before we jump off into our photo editors, you need to grab some templates that will help you make sure that all of your channel art and your picture is all in the right place for your channel banner. This is the page that you got to go to. Now that you saw the URL, let's talk a little bit about this page. There's only two things you really need to get off this page because I'm going to tell you everything you need to know. But you need to download the templates. Now, if you're using a photo editor like paint.net or something that does not accept Photoshop or PSD files, then you need to jump up on the channel art template fireworks. And if you have Photoshop or Photoshop elements, then you need to download the channel art template with Photoshop and the parens. That's all you need to know about that. So let's start off with paint.net. Important piece of this, the background that you use has to be 2560 by 1440 pixels. That is the dimension that you need your background to be so that it will fit TV, your desktop, mobile. It'll fit on any of those platforms and your channel art will look beautiful across all of them. 2560 by 1440. Now, I've already changed my background to 2560 by 1440, so I'm not going to do that in this tutorial. In paint.net, what we need to do is go to Layers, Import from File, and the first thing I'm going to import is going to be the background. And as you can see, if I hover over it, I've already made it 2560 by 1440 pixels. So I'm going to click on that, and then I'm going to click Open. Now, we need to go ahead and add another layer. So I'm going to go to Layers, Import from File, and I'm going to put the channel art with fireworks on here. So I'm going to click on that and click on Open. Now, right now, all you see is the channel art template. But as you can see down here in the layers box, I can uncheck it, and then I see my background. So I'm going to leave it checked right now because I need to know that everything I'm placing is being put in the right place. We want to focus on making sure everything stays in the text and logo safe area. This is 1546 by 423. If we focus on putting everything in this area, then what happens is no matter where someone views our YouTube channel, they will see all of the information that we put there. So I'm going to go to Layers, Import from File, and I'm going to put this little crystal ball with my head in it, and I'm going to click on Open. Now I'm going to place my cursor up onto this grab point. I'm going to hold down my shift key and I'm going to hold down my left mouse. I'm going to drag this down. What that does is it makes sure that everything keeps its aspect ratio and I don't skew it. Then I'm going to let go of my left mouse and left go shift. And I'm going to left click it and drag it into place here. It's too big. So I'll do the same thing, make it smaller so that it fits in the area. And make sure that I center it best I can. And that's pretty good. All right, so then you just add whatever other layers of pictures and things that you want. All of these layers that I'm putting on here are files that I created with a transparent background, and they are .png images with the transparency saved so that you can see through the background and all you see is the image. Now, what I need to do next is I need to get rid of this template. So I'm going to go down here once again to the layers, and I'm going to uncheck the channel art. And now all you see is my image, and it's good to go. All we got to do now is go to File, Save As. And we'll name it Channel Art 2. And we're going to save it as a JPEG file. And we'll click Save. And OK. If it has to let it flatten, go ahead and flatten it out. All that means is that it's not going to have layers anymore. You're good to go. We're done with Paint.net. Let's knock this out in Photoshop. So in Photoshop, I'm going to go to File, Open. And for this one, I actually have the PSD file for Photoshop, but I also have a PSD of a 2560 by 1440 image which has layers in it, which I'm going to use to give the photo more depth. So I'm going to click on that one and click on Open. And here are all my layers here. There's different layers of smoke. I can move them, I can undo them, all of that good stuff. And then I'm going to go to File, Place, and I'm going to choose the PSD of the channel art that I downloaded off of the support page for Google. I'm going to click on Place, and I want to make sure that this is visible, as visible as possible. So I'm going to move this all the way up to the top for now. Well, let me say that I'm okay with this by clicking on the checkbox first. And now I'm going to left click and drag this all the way up to the top. So now it's above every other layer. And now I can do the same thing. File, Place. Click what I want. Click Place again. Bring it down to size. Drag it into place. All right, so now that we got all of this stuff in place, what I'm gonna do is I'm going to make the channel art template disappear by unchecking it here. And now we just see all of this image. But also, I'm gonna move some of these images down into the clouds by moving them into different layer positions. And you can see the clouds go over some of these things now as I move these pieces around, which is a good thing about using Photoshop and different layers, is that you can actually give the photo more depth by making the clouds appear to be in front of things and stuff like that. So I like it like that. I'm gonna leave it like that. So now once again, we go to File, Save As. Make sure we choose a JPEG. And we'll call this one Channel Art. And we'll click on Save. Now that we got everything saved, let's jump off into YouTube and let's add some channel art. So I'm here on my YouTube page and I'm going to click on the add channel art. If you already have some channel art, then you can basically just click on this edit and do edit channel art if you already have channel art on here. But since I don't, I'm just going to click on add channel art. It's going to ask me to select a photo from my computer. So I'm going to click on that. I'm going to select the channel art that I created with the Photoshop. And I'm going to click on open. Now it gives me a look at, like, here's how it's going to look on your different devices. As you can see, desktop, everything fits. TV, it all fits. Even on a phone or a tablet, it all fits. Even my little men, because of where I place them when I use a template to set up the art. So it says that you can adjust crop if you want. I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to go ahead and click on select. It'll save it and boom. Channel art's in place, looking mighty lovely, if I should say so myself. There it is. Easy peasy, lemon squeezy, channel banner art for your YouTube channel. All right, guys, you know the routine. The thumb, the one that's pointed in the upward direction. Click it, like it, live it, love it, hug it. Show the thumb some love. Comment. You know I love comments. Leave me questions. I'll give you answers. All right? You need help? You're in the right place. Don't forget. Subscribe. Click on the little button to the side. Get your sub on. Get your sub on. And if you need some more YouTube love, all you gotta do is watch these videos. Watch these videos. You guys know what to do, so get to clicking.